The 2020 World Series has come to an end. The MLB season is over. The bubble, the shortened season, it's over. Really thankful it happened. But the World Series, that's what we're here to talk about. It is over. It was a great series with one of the craziest endings I've ever seen. One of the craziest endings you've ever seen, too. Get over yourself. Dodgers won in six. Not to brag. Called in six. I did say Kershaw was going to win MVP. That wasn't the case. It was Corey Seager. And he deserved it. He batted like 470 or something, or over 400. He was unbelievable. And Mookie Betts looked amazing too. Stole a bunch of bases, got everyone a taco. The Red Sox are probably shooting themselves in the dick. So that's always great to see. Very, very happy for Clayton Kershaw. He deserves it. He finally got one. He probably should have got one in the other two World Series because the Astros fucking cheated. And then the Red Sox, I'm pretty sure, fucking cheated too. So he should have had one by now, but really happy he finally got one. He definitely deserved it. He's a Hall of Famer. And yeah, like I said before, Game 4 was fucking insanity. One of the craziest endings I've ever seen in a sports game. Unfucking believable. I don't even know who to blame here. People are blaming Dave Roberts. I didn't really watch all of the game. I'm sorry, I just kind of missed it. There was college football on and I was out and things like that. But it sounds like it's Dave Roberts' fault for some reason, even though there was like four errors on one play. A guy missed the ball in center field, and then a guy tripped over the base running, and then he threw it home and he missed it. It was fucking insanity. How do you win off of like four errors? One of the craziest endings I've ever seen to a game. And then game six last night was great to watch, even though people might have thought it was boring. I thought it was interesting. All right, we'll talk about it. Kevin Cash pulling Blake Snell in the sixth inning. Now, I understand the analytics say you pull him there because when a pitcher faces a batter for the third time, statistically, the batter should probably get a hit at his third attempt at the same pitcher. Now, maybe that works. It seemed like it did work because they got to the World Series, and it seems like a lot of other teams are doing the same thing. But Blake Snell was putting up numbers last night that were matching only Sandy Koufax in the World Series. He was pitching the game of his life. He was on fucking fire. He only let up two hits. And you pull the guy? I don't get it. And I know it's because of analytics is why he did it. But I still don't fucking get it. And from what everyone's saying on Twitter, Kevin Cash throughout the series seemed to be outmanaging Dave Roberts. But he really choked last night. How do you pull Blake Snell there? It looked like the Dodgers had no answer for him. He was on fucking fire. This is definitely something that Rays fans will be thinking about for a very long time. It's going to raise a big argument. Should we just burn analytics to the ground? Should we bury it? And I think the answer is no. Analytics seems to work. But there are times I feel like in a game that you just got to think with your gut. You got to think what players are feeling and just roll with it. Instead of looking at a fucking spreadsheet saying, oh, if we take Snell out here, statistically, it should work. No, he was on fire. Players didn't know what to do about him. They should have kept him in. And I know hindsight's 20/20, but I'm pretty sure everyone in the world was thinking the same thing. Blake Snell was even like, what the fuck? I think everyone thought the same thing. He should have kept Blake Snell in. Oh, and Justin Turner had COVID throughout the whole game? Does that mean everyone was infected? What if they lost the game? Would they have to play game 7? Or they have to forfeit or like reschedule? What the fuck were they going to do? And I thought it was very strange that his test results were inconclusive, but he played anyway. Then they found out in the second inning that he tested positive, but he got pulled in the eighth. So it took six innings, which is like 2 hours, for them to call the dugout and be like, hey, Justin, you gotta get the fuck out of here. Seems pretty sketchy. I don't want to speculate or cause any theories or be like a crazy conspiracy theorist or anything like that. But that's just a little weird to me. And then he went and celebrated with his teammates and his wife after he tested positive. He probably should have been quarantining. Not a great look on his part. Now a lot of people are going to ask, is there an asterisk on this title? Because there was only 60 games in the regular season, and they played in a bubble, yada, 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 all that shit. I'm going to say yes and no. Classic me playing on the fence. Because I'm going to say yes because it was a very shortened season. You didn't even play half of the games. So I think there's an asterisk because of that. But at the same time, no. One, because everyone was in the same circumstance. And it is a really tough environment. It's a really shitty circumstance that everyone's in that had to deal with it. And like I said at the beginning of the video, it seems like the Dodgers probably should have had a World Series by now, but the opponents were cheating. So I feel like they deserve it. So yes and no. There you go. It's probably going to piss off both sides, but that's my take. Oh, and Rob Manfred, are you okay, buddy?
You thrilled our fans throughout the postseason with a great performance. You led the Dodgers to a World Series victory.
I think Robbie's fucking wasted. But yeah, that's the 2020 World Series. I thought it was a great series. I'm really glad we got an MLB season, even though it was very short, and it did feel so short. But it's better than nothing. We had sports for a while. It's going to be weird not having sports every single night for a little bit. Well, I mean, we at least have football. Thank God for that. But we got baseball. The season happened. Congratulations to the Dodgers. And mostly congratulations to Clayton Kershaw. You fucking deserve it. Let's go. So the 2020 World Series. Let me know what you guys thought of it or what your favorite moment was. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching. Click here to see more of Dave's Takes.